In our last session, we studied the first half of the book of Acts. Our theme word was power, and our title, The Explosive Power of the Spirit. It all begins at Pentecost, 50 days after Passover, or the Last Supper, in the upper room in Jerusalem, where the followers are waiting as Jesus instructed them. The Holy Spirit comes upon them like a rush of a violent wind, and divided tongues as of fire. They begin to speak in native languages. The power of the Holy Spirit thrusts the believers into a worldwide ministry. We see the action of the Holy Spirit in the witness of Stephen, who became the first Christian martyr. Philip baptized in the Ethiopian eunuch, which resulted in the gospel spreading to the continent of Africa. Saul's conversion. Saul, later called Paul, is a fierce persecutor of the followers of Jesus, who is blinded while on the road to Damascus and becomes a believer in Christ. And Peter's vision at Joppa, which dramatically influences the rules for Gentiles converting to Christianity. The Holy Spirit is never in conflict with God or Jesus. All the attributes we give to Jesus and God, such as counselor, guide, comforter, friend, advocate, truth, and love, we can also give to the Holy Spirit. The mark of discipleship was, disciples experience the presence and the power of the Holy Spirit in their lives and witness to others in order to lead them to Jesus. This week's theme word is conversion, and our title, The Gospel Penetrates the World. Jesus told his followers to go into all the world with the good news. In Acts, we learn the exciting story of just how they fulfilled that command. It wasn't just their passion and obedience that scattered them to share the truth about Christ. It was also persecution. When Jesus' followers were persecuted in Jerusalem, they fanned out first into major cities, and then, as they faced more opposition, they spread into small towns and villages everywhere, taking the good news of a risen Savior with them. As believers moved out into the entire Mediterranean world, they went first to Jewish synagogues, but they quickly fanned out into Gentile cultures. It was great timing in history to take the gospel to the world, since the common language of Greek helped them communicate, and Roman roads and Roman peace made travel easier than ever before. In a plot twist only God could engineer, Paul, who had once been a tormentor of the new Christian movement, was now its greatest messenger. After his dramatic conversion, Paul spent about 15 years learning and growing in his faith in Jesus Christ before he launched out on 4 missionary journeys. The explosive power of the Holy Spirit is seen in the astonishing stories of Paul's adventures. Once, he had a vision of a man calling for help in Macedonia, and that resulted in Paul taking the gospel to the continent of Europe. Another time, Paul and Silas were thrown in prison, but what began as a setback led to the conversion of the very man guarding the jail. Paul was beaten, stoned, shipwrecked, and snake-bitten, but he persisted in his calling to preach and share the good news. In fact, each time forces moved to stop Paul's movement, it only seemed somehow to turn circumstances to his advantage for witnessing in the end. Paul had an amazing gift for entering any culture or context and using what he found there to communicate the truth about Jesus. He could reason with Jews in the synagogue or banter with Greeks in the marketplace. When he found among pagan altars on Mars Hill in Athens, an altar with the inscription, "To an unknown God," Paul saw his chance to introduce the Athenians to the Jesus who longed to know them and be known by them. Some people sneered at his message, but others listened and were intrigued, and a handful joined him and became believers. The culture in which we find ourselves is never empty of God's grace. There are signs of Christ's love and presence all around us, wherever we find ourselves. Paul used every gift, talent, and experience to witness to the love of Christ. Wherever life takes us, we can learn from Paul to notice and call attention to the grace of God that has gone before us, and to tell people joyfully about the love and hope found in Jesus Christ.